morning to all of you, and this is Dr. Khanna from the Department of English, and today we are going to discuss the poem called The Road Not Taken. The Road Not Taken is a small poem written by Robert Frost, and Robert Frost is one of the best American poets in English literature, and he published this poem in the year 1916. On behalf of the Department of English, today I am going to explain the poem called The Road Not Taken. The Road Not Taken is a very simple poem written by Robert Frost. Let us have a look at the introduction of the poet now. Robert Lee Frost was born on March 26, 1874 in New England, and he happens to be one of the best poets in American literature, and most of his poems were published in England before they are published in America. He is highly regarded as the realistic poet in English literature, and of course he is highly regarded for his realistic depiction of rural life. If you see the poem's title, The Road Not Taken, it's a very simple poem based on a common sense here, because the language is very simple, and here the road is the symbol of our life. Road is symbol of the choice that we make in our life. Many times we regret about the choice that we have made in the past. Usually man regrets what he has denied himself in life rather than what he has chosen. So hence the poet has given this poem the title The Road Not Taken. So the word road means, it not only means way, it also means a journey or a stage of journey here. Here the road does not signify any ordinary road here, but it functions a metaphor of vital decision in our life now. Let us have a look at the poem now. So the poem is well known. So the well-known poem is about making choices and the choices that shape us. Robert Frost is an American poet who writes simply but insightfully about common and ordinary expenses in his poetry. In The Road Not Taken, Robert Frost makes a fascinating use of two roads as a metaphor of life. And two roads serve as metaphors for the choices we make in our life. Thus, the two roads are in fact the alternatives of life. The choice we make has an important life, and it has far-fetching consequence here. And the poet leaves the first road for some other time, and he chooses the second road, and he believes that he would come back for the second road, but the fact is that we know the fact that he will never come back for the second road again. So if you see the poem in just now, the poet brings a kind of a metaphorical journey in his life now. The poet brings about making a choice in life here. And Frost uses two important roads here as metaphors for life, and they stand for the choices and two alternatives of life here, and the two different directions of life. The choice we make in our life, that has made all the difference here. That's very important. And the poet stands at a junction and in a yellow wood where he is confused to choose between the two roads now. So he looks at the first road for a long time and observes, and finally he comes to a conclusion that both roads are very similar, and definitely out of such similarity, and he could identify that one road is less traveled by the people. So perhaps that is the reason why he becomes a poet, because the poem is based on two important aspects here. One is, it is an autobiographical poem, and it is also a kind of a metaphorical poem. Why is it an autobiographical poem? Because it is based on his own experiences. Basically, he was a farmer. So he was in a confusion between two professions here, whether he would go for a farmer or a poet. So finally, at this juncture, and he chooses to become a poet, and we all know the fact of what happened at the end. He became the most successful poet in English literature. In this way, it is called an autobiographical poem. And what is the metaphorical poem? So the poem is based on a metaphorical journey of the poet, and he uses two metaphors here, that is the road. What does road symbolize? The road symbolizes the choice in our life, because every one of us, and we have the choices in our life since we are born until we go to the death. So every moment of our life, we encounter innumerable times in our life which one to choose. And sometimes we don't find the two, we find sometimes even more than 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the number becomes innumerable sometimes to choose. But finally, when it comes to the choice between the two here, and we have to observe, this life is very important for us to choose here. And once we choose, we cannot go back to the past life and to choose the second choice, that what we have left so far. So that's why the poet advises us not to regret about the choice that we have made, and whatever the choice we made in our life, and we should look forward to achieve the success in our life. So in the poem The Road Not Taken, the poet brings out a beautiful theme of the choices in common man's life here. And the poet says that the path which is not taken is nothing but the road not taken here. But though the poet tells about the road which he has taken, but sometimes at the end of the poem we understand that he also talks about the road which is not taken by himself. Because every time most of us think that we are not happy what we have with us. We always think of the things that we have left in the past and we have ignored in the past. So that is the regret that we most of us do in our life here. Let us see the poem now. I will read the first stanza. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both. And be one traveler long I stood, and looked down as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. If you see the first line of the poem, two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Here the poet talks about the season also, metaphorically, that is yellow wood. What is yellow wood? So the place or the road where the poet encounters a divergence of the road into, I mean, where the road is split in two ways, you know, and the two ways are covered in yellow wood. That means two ways are covered with yellow leaves. And you know what are the yellow leaves? All the yellow leaves are fallen leaves from the trees during the autumn season. So, and we also call it as the fall season here. So the season which is in the middle of the two seasons, like summer and winter, and autumn season, during the autumn season, you know what happens? All the trees shed their leaves here. It also symbolizes that the people who are reaching old age now. If you look at the summary of the first stanza here, and when one day when the poet was walking in the woods, and he comes across the divergence of the two roads there. And there he gets confused, because we know the fact that he is one traveler, and there is a destination for everyone definitely in their life. And even you and I also have the destination. But to reach the destination, to reach the success, we have number of ways here. But the thing is, we must be wise in making our choice to reach the destination. That is a very important aspect. So similarly, the poet encounters these two roads in that yellow wood, where the roads are completely covered by. And so in that circumstances here, he is constrained to choose only one out of the two roads now here. So the poet says that he was only one traveler, that he was only one person, but he could not travel on the two roads at a time here. That we all know is a very simple logic, that you can't take the two roads at a time. And you may reserve the other road for some other time, but in the journey of life, you cannot come back and choose the second path again here. So he had to choose only one out of these two roads here. And especially the roads which are covered by this yellow wood. So yellow wood means here, I told you that a forest which is covered by all the leaves which are shed from the trees during autumn season here. So that represents the world a world which is full of people where you find the people who are older than the poet here. So the poet kept standing for a long time to observe the two roads which is the better claim for him. Claim means a better choice for him to go ahead actually while walking on the road here. So before taking the decision, he wanted to observe the two roads here. Just like I tell you some of the examples here, that generally when we go for a shopping, when we go for something to buy, you know, that we will look for different options there, that which one is the best and which one is the better. So similarly, the poet is standing at the junction, looking the two roads carefully as long as he could see such a long distance. And why does he look at carefully now? Why? What is his observation? His observation is very clear, that he wants to see as long as he could see which one, which road gives him success and which road gives him the better journey in his life here. So when he observes closely the two roads, when he monitors closely the two roads, and he identifies that one road later that I will tell you. So what is he doing? That he is looking at the two roads as long as he could see. Perhaps the roads must have curves somewhere else, you know. So till the roads are curved, till the roads are bent, sudden long distance, the poet has been observing the two roads very carefully. To what extent? To where it bent in the undergrowth. So undergrowth means here, undergrowth is nothing but bushes, you know, because you can't see the road in the forest some kilometers and kilometers. You may see only a couple of meters only. So and after that, he is trying to observe the hidden road behind that, whether it gives him better success or not after the road is over. So that's about the first stanza. The first stanza, what is happening? The poet describes about his position, where he is standing exactly. That he has been out one day for walking, and where he comes across the two roads that he is encountered, and he is constrained to choose only one road since he is only one passenger or one traveler in the forest. And what does he do? And he stands there for a long time to look as long as he could see the two roads at their bending position, and even in the undergrowth also. That is, the roads are covered with bushes, and the roads, these two roads are completely in yellow color also. Why yellow color? I told you that. Well, let us see the second stanza now. Then took the other just as fair, and having perhaps the better claim, because it was grassy and wanted wear. Though as for that passing wear, had warned them really about the same. So if you see the connectivity from the previous stanza, where the poet was obstructed to choose between two alternative roads, and finally he has to take it because he cannot stop his journey, he has to go forward. So finally he comes to a conclusion with one particular road. But how does he measure, and how does he take the decision, and how does he finalize his decision to choose only one of the two roads now here? So then took the other just as fair. So that means, took the other means that he had already seen one road which is not exactly as fair as the second road now. So he said that I took the other just as fair. That means there is one road, perhaps it is said that he looks, the road looks, perhaps the road looks somehow better claim. That means when we observe close, the poet has observed the two roads very closely now, and finally he comes to a conclusion that one road looks better for him to move ahead actually from that place. Because it was grassy and wanted way. What was grassy and wanted way? The other road. Because he mentioned in the first line that, what is the first line? It is mentioned that, then took the other, then took the other just as for it. That means he was talking about the other road which was not taken by him. And what is it about? How is that road? He describes very beautifully that because it was grassy and wanted wear. What was grassy? The other road which was not taken. That was still with grassy. You know what happens in the villages, you know, when today we have all these roads, sophisticated tar roads or cement roads, all these roads, you know, but in those days, you know, in the olden days, when the people used to go walk, and when the people used to walk through the forest, you know, they used to have their own roads, that is, we call as footpath also sometimes, you know. And when people keep walking continuously in one way, definitely there won't be any grass on the road. But here the poet gets surprised to see the road. One road was particularly covered with grass here. So that is one aspect that made him to choose the other now. Okay, which is looking as fair as the other road now. So that is one reason. And wanted where? Wanted where means that there is a need for walking. If the people walk, then only it is used. So that is one aspect. Though as far as the passing there had warned them really about the same, but the fact what he tells us that both roads look alike. There won't be much difference between the two roads now. But that is the most difficult task for the poet to choose which one is the better claim for him. Because nobody had trodden and nobody had traveled, and he took the risk, because there is a risk in choosing the road which is less traveled by usually. So he has taken that decision to go in some other way where people have not traveled more. So that is the less traveled road that he is preferring now to choose. So here in the second line, if you observe that a better claim, what is that better claim here? A claim stands for a kind of a choice now. A claim stands for a kind of better option for him actually. So he comes to a conclusion that he wants to go for the second option, which is not looking, perhaps even though the road was looking grassy, it needs the people to walk. So he wants to take the chance now. He wants to take the lead now to travel or to take the second road, which is not as good as the other road now. You see the second stanza summary clearly now. So he looked down the first one where it bent in the underneath now, that undergrowth, and he understands that both roads very closely and which is good and which is not good there. And then the second one he decided to take as his choice now here, because it seemed to have less travel by, because the road looks as if it were traveled by less people actually in the forest now. But the fact is that both roads are very similar. But when for his observation, and he finds the second road which is less traveled by the people, and that's why he feels that that is the better option, and he decides to take the second one there. So the second one that he took seems less traveled, but as he thinks about it, he realizes now. What does he realize? That they were really about the same. Both roads look like, I told you, I've been telling the same, that both roads are not so different. Both roads are looking same because both roads are covered by the yellow woods, that is yellow leaves, the leaves which are fallen during the autumn season. So, but finally, after having observed carefully, he decides to take the second road which is less traveled. How do we understand that the road is less traveled by? Because he says in the second line that it was grassy and wanted way. That means the road is still covered by the grassy, where the people have not much travel on this particular road. Now let us have a look at the third stanza. I'll read out. And both that morning equally lay, in leaves no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. So after having chosen the second road here, because it is said in the second stanza that he prefers to choose the second road which is less traveled by many people, that so he looks for the second road which is not traveled by many people, and he feels that it is a better claim also for him. Now in the third stanza he is trying to explain the reader that why it is his choice now, and why did he choose the second particular road only, which is less traveled by here. Because in the morning when he goes for a walk, you know, that when he encounters this particular task of choosing between the two roads, he identifies in the morning that both roads equally lay. That means the leaves or the grass or whatever he observes in the morning, he identifies that both roads look almost the same here. And in the second road which he has chosen, you know, that what happened in the leaves, that nobody has walked so far. The trodden means trodden black means that nobody that's walked. No trodden black, that means no step had trodden black means nobody has walked on this particular road. That's why he wants to take the task, the most challenging task in his life. And as we all know that what happened at the end of his life, that he became the most successful poet in American literature. So the poet said that the both paths or the both roads are similar actually to his observation now, in the morning especially. But there is a slight difference between the two roads in his observation now. What is the slight difference, you see? But both had leaves on them and no one had stepped on the leaves now. No one had stepped on the leaves especially, as they were still green in color and as they were still in fresh actually in their color. If somebody walked on the leaves, what happens? The leaves would have definitely changed into black color, or the leaves would have definitely changed into some other color here. So that means he feels that the road looks very fresh for him in that morning, just like his career. Okay, so most of the time we always prefer to choose the road which is traveled by many people, which is more traveled road usually, because we know the success at the end. And somebody became a doctor, somebody became an engineer, somebody became blah 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 like this, you know. So we set the goal which is seen completely from this end to that end. But only rare people like the poet who set the goal in this hidden road which is having a lot of chases, difficulties and problems in the life of their journey. Well, if you look at the stanza 3, the summary of the stanza 3, it's a very simple that, because the poet goes continuously telling something about the differences between the two roads, that why he has chosen that particular road only here. So the third stanza continues the cognition about the possible differences between the two roads here, and he had noticed that he had noticed in the morning that the leaves were both fresh fallen on them from the trees. So he believes strongly that nobody had walked actually on the leaves now. And maybe that is one reason that why he has chosen that particular way which is less travel. Probably even the other one is also travel, but both roads, when he observes both roads carefully, he understands that one road is less traveled by the people, and that gives him strength, that gives him to choose, and he feels that it is the best claim for him and to choose for his journey there. Well, now the fourth stanza. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Now, if you look at the first line, I shall be telling this with a sigh. What is sigh? We're taking a deep breath now. How do we take? When do we take this a deep breath, you know, after completing our journey? After completing our journey, when we reach that particular point in of time in our life, you know that. So when we look back, definitely you would remember the junction where you took this particular road. So that's why he says that I shall be telling this, shall be, he uses the word. What is shall be? Shall be stands for the future tense. Definitely. When he goes to the future, a particular place where he wants to reach, or the goal, or the destination, or the success, and definitely he takes the breath, a deep breath there, and tells something about the past, that he has taken the decision in the past at one particular point of time here. What is that he tells in the past? Somewhere ages and ages, because ages and ages is referred. So it's related to a particular age in the past, that where he was constrained to take that particular decision to travel only one way but not the other way there. He was traveling his life journey and he came across two important decisions in his life. or two important choices in his life, and where he was constrained to take this particular way now. And so perhaps he would regret sometimes. And the sigh, the deep breath also indicates us some kind of regret, understand that. So definitely one must be telling the same in the future, either with his children or with somebody else, you know, that no, in those days, you know, that when I had the two choices in my life, you know, that I took this particular thing, that and I had faced a lot of problem. I had I've been troubled a lot because my friend who took the other road and he went so easily and he was successful. Like this, we keep telling a kind of complaining about ourselves sometimes in the future also. So he recollected the sentence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, understand that. And that has made all the difference now. Suppose if there are two friends, understand that, one traveled in one way and the other traveled in this way. And definitely there would be comparison between two friends now in the future, that when they reached their destination, and he says that I would have come that way and I would have come this way, understand that. So, but what the poet was trying to tell us in this simple poem, one should not regret about the past. Because what is the fact that we should realize now here? The fact is that you cannot go back to the same time where you took this decision, understand that. Because is it possible to go back in life? That is impossible to go back, understand. So similarly in future, when you grow up, so when you become, when you are successful in your life, understand that. Definitely you will say, sharing with your friends, sharing with your wife and children, understand that in future that once upon a time, use you the word, once upon a time there were two options for me. So there were two options for me. One was a police constable, or one was the department of police, and the other one is a teacher. One is a doctor and the other one is an engineer. And like this, we come across a lot of choices in our life. So this is a very strong message for all the students also. Because I just want to tell you with some of the most incidents that I experienced in my lifetime as a teacher. Because usually after having completed SSC, and students will have four options there. That is MPC, BIPC, CEC, OHEC, like this, you know. So you, most of the time, probably your parents will influence you by the time that you choose this and you choose that, and because everybody becomes an engineer so easily, and some becomes a doctor so easily. So so doctor's life is very comfortable, and engineer's life is very comfortable, and the career in groups is also very comfortable. Like this, people keep influencing the people by the time. Okay, then afterwards, you know, suppose if you study in intermediate, either MPC, BIPC or whatever, and you have again the same courses, you know, like an engineer will have a lot of branches, you know, like electricals, electronics, mechanicals, civils, computers, etc. And similarly, even a BIPC student also will have, suppose if he gets, if he fails to get medicine, you know, and he looks for the other courses which are available, like agriculture, BSc or like this. So everywhere, life is nothing but choice, understand that. Because every moment of your life, you will be choosing something either between the two or among the multiple choices, you know that. So that is one aspect. And you are a grown-up child now. That. So after completing your graduation, the real challenge comes to you all now. That. What next, you know that? So after completing your graduation, what next? You completed your graduation in BSc sciences, you know, or mathematics, or arts or commerce sometimes, you know, that what next, you know, because you're going to become a unique person now with your graduation now. So you must be very wise before you take the decision, because once you take the decision, this is a very crucial time for us, because you cannot go back now to the 10th class, you cannot go back to the intermediate, you cannot go back even to the first year degree also. Got it? And finally, you did something, that you made something, that made all the difference, understand that, what poet says at the end. So you made it different finally, and now you have to achieve only from the choice that you have made so far in your life. Because as poet already said that he, you cannot go back. You cannot go back and study again 10th class. You cannot go back and study again intermediate.
you cannot go back and study again another degree. So this is a very crucial time for you too, because past is past. Whatever happened is happened. Don't look back, understand that. Look forward and look, think, observe, just like the poet, how the poet observed carefully the two roads as long as he could see. That one must have that foresight. If I choose this particular field, what would be the result? If I choose this particular way, will I reach the destination? So think wisely now. Don't think foolishly, understand that. Don't think foolishly and regret later. So think wisely and be happy even after the end of your journey. Definitely you would be very happy. Let me explain you some of the practical experiences of the people in the society, you know that. And somebody regarding the marriage especially, you know that. A girl will have a lot of options, and the boy also will have a lot of options to marry someone, unless and until it is a love marriage where you find a compulsion, understand that. But in this arranged marriage, what happens? The parents influence you sometimes, the neighbors will influence you sometimes, and this boy is the best and this girl is the best, like this, you know. And so you are in a state of confusion which one to choose. It is your life, because generally the parents are well wisher to you. Definitely they will help you a lot, and they will look for your bright future, definitely, however they have done so far in your life, understand that. So now you are able to take the decision, okay. And suppose between arranged marriage and love marriage, and you prefer love marriage, for example, because you fought with your parents and fought with your friend, you fought with somebody else, and finally you married someone whom you like the most. But after a couple of years, what happens, you know, most of the marriages, you know, that we came across, I'm not against to this, I'm not either against to this one or to that particular one. So in both marriages, you know, there will be problems. The problems are everywhere. So we have to encounter them. We have to face them wisely, understand that. We have to solve them. Because you can't take back life. If you take back life, that means that you have ruined your life, understand that. And you made, you proved yourself to be wrong actually with the decision that what you have taken so far. So don't ever regret about the choice that you have made so far in your life. And you go ahead with the problems, you go ahead with the challenges, you go ahead all these difficulties, because there are people, many people in this world who are living in worse condition than you, understand that. So think wisely before you take the decision, and don't regret about the decision that what you have made so far, and don't regret about the college that you joined, understand that. I would have joined that college and I would have joined this college and my parents not helped. Don't give any such complaints about the past, that whatever you have done so far. So this is a very important message for all the students here. Why does the regret comes to us, you know that? Usually the regret comes like this, you know that, because the professions that you have chosen now, or the career that you have chosen now, when it is not successful to you, definitely you would regret. Why would you regret, you know that? Perhaps that profession would be more rewarding or more rewarding for me, understand? No, that is one aspect that why people regret usually. That so let us not regret about the past, that what, because your future depends on you. Your future depends on the choice that you make today. So that what the poet is trying to tell us, you must be careful and you must be very wise before you take the decision today, because today you are going to take the decision. Well, I hope you all understand the poem, and let us just recap what exactly the poem is about. So the poem is written in 4 stanzas here, and each stanza is consisting of 5 lines here. And when we look at the rhyming scheme of this poem, so how do we identify the pattern of this rhyming scheme in the poem? If we see the first stanza carefully, and the rhyming scheme of this poem is identified or seen at the end of every word. So if you see the first line, you find the word at the end, would, and the third line, stood, and the fourth line, could. So the first, third, and the fourth line are the same rhyming words. If you see the other two lines, that is the second line and the fifth line, they are pronounced as both and undergrowth. So these two represent the other letter now. So what is the rhyming scheme? The rhyming scheme of this stanza is AB, AA, B. I hope you understand the rhyming scheme. And if you observe the other three stanzas also, you find the same rhyming scheme here, because the poet manages, or the poet uses such a wonderful language in this poem. So it's a very simple poem based on two important aspects I told you now. One is, it is an autobiographical element, and it is also a metaphorical element here. So if you see the four stanzas carefully, the first stanza tells about the poet's position, that where he comes across the confusion state to take a decision. And in the second stanza, he takes a decision after examining carefully the two roads now. And in the third stanza, he explains that why he had chosen the less traveled, why not the more traveled road. And finally, in the fourth stanza, he tells something about the future after having reached that particular goal, or after having reached that particular ambition or achievement, understand that in his life. Because one must go to the future, because he has already chosen the road. So when you reach, when you grow up in the future, definitely you refer the past experiences in that you made a choice in your life. Well, dear students, so this is all about the poem, The Road Not Taken, written by Robert Frost. And I hope you all enjoyed the poem. Well, thank you for watching my video. Have a nice day.